Hello students, today we are going to study class science bio and please turn to page number 52 of your textbook. Today we are going to deal with chapter number 3. Okay, fine, we have dealt with, just turn your page. The chapter is chapter number 3, kingdom classification 2. Okay, in earlier video I have just dealt with phylum Porifera, and today we are going to deal with, come again to page number 52, okay? And today we are going to deal with phylum Cnidaria or Colentrata. So, Cnidaria, Colentrates, it means hollow gut, okay? It means hollow gut. So we are going to deal with the first point, aquatic, living in water, mostly marine. A few such as hydra are freshwater. It means the organisms that belong to this phylum are mostly aquatic. It means they live in water and most of them are marine. That means most of them survive in the salty water, but few survive in the freshwater sources. Okay. Now, second point. A central gastrovascular cavity, colenteron, is present which lacks anus but has a mouth which is surrounded with short and slender tentacles. So, first of all, gastrovascular. Gastrovascular means it's a primary organ for digestion and circulation process. Okay, in this gastrovascular cavity, what is happening? The preliminary starting steps of digestion and circulation is happening because these organisms doesn't have well developed, well functional digestive or the circulatory system. It's happening in a cavity, and this cavity enclosed both this digestive and the circulatory process, the preliminary steps in this cavity, which is known as a gastrovascular cavity, and the name of this cavity is colenteron. One word for this cavity is colenteron. Okay, and it lacks anus and the mouth. As you can see, the mouth will be surrounded with short and slender tentacles. It means tapering, cylindrical, slender. Okay, short, the length will be short, and the slender tentacles. It means tentacles means some hair like outgrowth. Okay, the length of the tentacles will not be too long. It is a short tentacles. Okay, now respiratory and circulatory excretory organs are absent. As I told you, these organisms are primitive kind of. They don't have well-developed circulatory, respiratory or excretory systems. Okay, a cavity is present there, which is known as colenteron. And here the primary steps of these very processes is going on. So, it doesn't have this well-developed organs for these very systems. Okay. Now, fourth point. Nervous system is primitive, has only network of nerve cells. As I told you, they organization, okay, is not well developed. As for example, in human beings, what is happening? We have a well developed organization. We have a separate system for digestion, for excretion, for circulation, for nervous system, okay, different kind of system that are specialized to perform a particular functions. But this kind of specialization is not formed in the organisms that belong to this phylum, that is Cnidaria. Okay, so they have only few nerve cells that perform the functions. Their mouth is surrounded by a number of finger-like projections called tentacles. It is a finger-like projections. You can see your fingers now, slender. Okay, in the same way, the tentacles are present. These projections possess stinging cells, which help them in anchoring, defense, and arresting prey. What they do, these tentacles, they stick to certain things. Okay. And they stick, for example, a prey is coming. Okay? The prey is coming. Then this tentacle, this finger-like projections, what will they? They will just hold up. First of all, they are going to stick to the prey. Then it will just hold it tightly. Okay? And just, it don't allow the prey to move out away from its tentacles. Once the prey is caught, it can't move away. ओके, एंड इट ऑल्सो हेल्प देम इन डिफेंस टू प्रोटेक्ट देमसेल्व्स फ्रॉम अदर ऑर्गेनिजम्स. एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सिनिडेरियंस आर हाइड्रा, जेलीफिश एंड सी एनिमो. दीज थ्री दी आर द थ्री एग्जाम्पल्स गिवन ओवर हियर फॉर द ऑर्गेनिजम्स दैट बिलोंग टू दिस फाइलम. ओके फाइन, नाउ नेक्स्ट फाइलम इज फाइलम प्लैटीहेल्मिंथेस. प्लैटी मीन्स फ्लैट, हेल्मिंथस मीन्स वॉर्म, इट मीन्स फ्लैट वॉर्म्स. प्लैटीहेल्मिंथेस मीन्स फ्लैट वॉर्म्स. ओके, नाउ बॉडी इज थिन एज यू कैन सी इन अ फिगर 3.2, लीवर फ्लूक दिस एग्जाम्पल. The body is flat, okay, you can see. And as it's a worm, the helminthus means worm. The body is thin, soft, leaf-like and or ribbon-like. Here you can see this body seems to be of leaf-like, okay, or it will be in the shape of ribbon. Flat means the bottom portion will be plain as well as the upward portion will be flat, plain, okay. They are triploblastic animals, implying that the tissues differentiate in from three embryonic germ cells. So the new word for you is triploblastic. What does triploblastic means? It means the organisms or the cells or the organs that is developed from the three layers: ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderms. From these three layers, germs layers, this animal has been developed. That's why it is known as the triploblastic. Okay, now come to the next column. They are without a body cavity, echinomate animals. It means they don't have any cavity. I told you, because they are the primitive organisms, they do not have well differentiated systems for performing every functions. A cavity is there, and in that very cavity, the preliminary steps of digestion, circulation, excretion is happening on. But in this organism, that body cavity is also absent. Cavity means simply a empty space, a column where some of the traces of the organs are present to perform some important functions of the body. Digestive cavity with a single opening, the mouth. The digestive cavity, in this cavity, the post-process of digestion is going to takes place, and what is happening? It's only single opening, that it's only mouth. Anus is not there. That means here excretion is not going to happen. Only digestion of the food is going to happen. Suckers and hook are usually present. So what is the function of the suckers? The suckers perform the function of absorption, and hooks for attachment. What is happening? These are the worms. The hooks will help the worm to stick to the whole body of the host. Okay, and after sticking from the body of the host, suckers will start absorbing the food from there. That's why they have suckers and hooks. Circulatory and respiratory system and skeleton are absent. As they are the primitive organism, they don't have the well-differentiated system. So the circulation, respiration and skeleton system is also absent. Hermaphrodite, it means the in the same body, they have both the male and female organs present in the same one organism. Okay? Now, the examples of the organism that belong to this phylum is Planaria and liver fluke. Okay? Now, we are going to deal with another phylum, that is phylum Nematoda. Okay? The body is worm-like, round, slender, tapering at the two ends, cylindrical, flattened. So the organism belonging to this category, it has a shape or has a body like just like a worm. Okay, it will be round in shape, slender, tapering at both the ends. It means at the ends it is going to have this tapering ends. You can see this now. This is known as this end, and this end will be known as the tapering ends. Flattened, it means flat. From the upper and the lower side, it will be flat. Okay? Cylindrical, just like cylindral. Okay? Cylindrical body. It means the body will be, have of equal length throughout the body. And at the end, it will have the tapering. It's going to be closed on. Body is covered with a tough resistance, cuticle and cilia absent. The body is covered with a tough resistance cuticle. So what is the function of cuticle? Is generally a layer that is perform the function of protection. Okay, this cuticle, so this organism body is covered with cuticle. Cuticle is a hard covering that protect the organisms. Okay, it perform the function of protecting the body. Cilia absent. Cilia means short hair like projections are there, which is known as cilia. Okay, something here like short hair like thing will be coming out of the body. Okay, covering the body, that is absent in this very organism. Alimentary canal straight and complete with mouth and anus. Here this organism has a well-developed alimentary canal. That means mouth and anus. That means the food will be taken in with the through the mouths, and after the complete process of digestion, whatever waste material is coming out, it's going to be thrown out through the anus. Okay. Now pharynx, okay, very important organ, is muscular. It means it is made up of muscles. No bones will be there. Okay, then sexes are separate. It means the here the two organisms we have will have the different sexes. Male as well as female members will be present in this phylum. Most forms are parasitic, but some are free living in soil and water. Most of them are parasitic. That means they are for food. They are dependent upon others. They just survive on other bodies. But some just live freely. They don't need any host. They just really freely in the soil or water. Now examples are roundworm, Scarus, and Cyclostoma, Vicheria, Bancrofti. Now Enterobius. Okay, so these are the organisms that belong to this very phylum. I have underlined the whatever are the important points. Okay, you can just write these very important points in your copies and learn it. I have written the meanings of all the new words. Okay, and what is the function is they are performing with pencils. Okay, that will be help you out in while your revision. Okay, fine. So the homework for today is to learn the different organism belonging to that very phylum. Today I have taught you three phylums. Okay, so you have to learn the name of the organisms, to name of the two organisms that belong to that very phylum, and plus you have to write the important points in your copy and learn that very points. Okay, thank you students. Stay safe, stay healthy.